35 miles an hour. If I do 35 miles an hour, I think I'm screwed. It's way too fast.
How fast are we going?
We're doing 24 right now. Sitting in my seat, nope.
I would not feel comfortable with you going 35 around some of these corners.
This ain't nothing yet. Wait till it gets bad. When it's curvy going downhill, because the gravity assist just really wants to throw you around. Steep curves uphill, you just kind of keep your foot in it and hope you're going to keep going. There's a guy really close behind me. I don't know what he's thinking. I would not follow me that close. Thinking. I'm gonna pass this guy, but there's no passing anywhere. Downhill, pretty steep grade here, so I'm just gonna let the transmission hold me back here, especially with 25 mile an hour curve coming up. We're doing 36. Gotta respect the 25 mile an hour warning.
20 miles an hour.
That one was a little muscular input. Here to the other side of the road.
At least.
I mean, that is like some Talladega banking right there. Like Ricky Bobby would have trouble walking up that. Left is our will be our property. It's a beautiful drive coming in.
Yay for power lines.
Yeah. Where do they go to though? They just end right there. That might be just telephone. That might not be power lines.
In 1/4 mile, turn left.
Find out. These are the kind of ruts that I drove across yesterday to back out of here. He didn't like it very much. Well, you can see there how we do have a lot of soil, clay soil, and rock. This is where it's been cut out. It just gives you a good idea. That's what we should expect. But there's a lot of chert. I see a school bus. There's a neighbor over there on top of the hill. Nobody lives in it because it's at a pretty steep angle.
Should have had him come through where the house was going to be. What are you wanting to see here? Just dirt without giant rocks? Okay.
Yeah. Depth of rock we look at, we look at the amount of clay, where the clay comes in, what kind of clay.
Okay.
So
you got the rock
there? I don't think we'll have a layer on that. Let's run that road trip.
Yeah.
Real good soil to build on, so you can build the foundation.
Excellent. So there's quite a few little rocks in there, like baseball, softball size.
But it's real good for drainage. You have some water through the soil.
How deep do you have to dig with this?
It's 3 foot. I got a very fine 3 foot.
Feet there.
Yep. All right. Well, I got it.
So everything looks good, like what you wanted to see?
Yeah. We're going to cover that up. Look out, dog.
So I got two short leaves. I know you want to see.
back with your leg, Kelly. Thank you. Clay there?
Yeah, but it's not a bad kind of clay. It's a good kind of clay.
Okay. So another one looks good?
It's not a mountain you sold it. It is pretty good sold. After all that rain we had, how well it rained.
Yeah.
A lot of places you got water standing everywhere. It's not even wet in the hole. Yeah.
So this one looks a little more churdy up higher, but that's not an issue.
Not at all. Man, the chert doesn't matter at all. It's really good for draining. The clay is the main thing.
Yeah, we got several inches of rain here over the last couple weeks, right? Or the last few days.
Over the last 2 days. Yeah. That's what I figured. You can use these church hills a lot more. Sometimes you hit layer rock and you hit a bad place.
Layer rock here is just limestone, is what you come across?
Yeah, there's siltstone, mudstone, sandstone, some places are close to mudstone, is what you get from on this. Layers of siltstone. It's usually on the lower part of the sand, but they can get the lower building.
Yeah.
Fill it in. They have to stay there, or I gotta come back and do this again, and you get to pay me again, and all that. So it'd be best to put fence posts up.
Okay.
And each one of these is five of them, I believe. One, two, three, four of them.
Robin!
This is our private drive again. It's that pretty cherty type rock here, so it's not muddy. It's been, we got like, I think you said like 4 inches of rain in the last 2 days, and there's no standing water here. It's not muddy. I'm not slipping or sinking. And even this road is really hidden from the road, or this driveway is hidden from the roadway there. You can't see anything. There's a berm on each side. About 25 acres here. Can't even see where the bus is parked up there. Got a little bit of standing water here on the side of the road, or the driveway. This is all going to be our property here. I think it's a beautiful entrance coming in where they've already cut this out here. I mean, there's giant boulders. Hanging out with a rock. Glad we didn't hit none of those today. It's gonna perk for, he did it set up for a 5-bedroom septic system is gonna be on there, so. We're not gonna have 5, but at least it'll have an overkill of that. So I just came back. We're at the campsite again after being out the property all day. And let the generator just sit. I haven't done anything to it. And on the way home, I hit the start button and it fired instantly up. Is loud because there's no muffler on it, but all it needed to do was dry out, so I didn't even have to work on it. I just need to let it dry, but now I got to come up with a way to protect it from the rain. We've never had that problem before. It's always got wet, but never had any issues. So whatever it was yesterday, it didn't like it, but the Onan is working just fine now. I just got to put the muffler back on it. I don't want to run it here at the campground because it'll be way too loud for that. It needs a muffler.